Tonight on IFAF.
Idaho Falls and firefighters.
I wonder if you've got some sort of
deficiency.
Yeah.
I've wondered that
or
too.
Imbalance. Karley already has, I'm going to tell on you, already has Halloween decorations up.
It's sort of cognitively weird because you look at it and you feel like you're about to eat a potato and then it's ice cream.
A soft swinging scandal in Provo, Utah, Utah County, Happy Valley.
Yeah, weird.
IFAF, Idaho Falls Local, Independent, Alternative Media, with Mike Nelson and Karley Morgan.
Welcome, new followers and viewers and listeners. It's so great to have you here for Idaho Falls Infotainment, Opinion, and Bad Jokes. We had a banner week last week.
Right.
Those numbers just kind of, they hockey sticked a little bit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm excited to see y'all.
Yeah, thanks for being here. Mm-hmm. Let YouTube know that you love this kind of stuff and click subscribe. There's a link here in this post on tonight's episode, The Secret Lives of Mormon Wives.
Who are maybe not so Mormon, by the way.
Right.
Yeah.
I don't know how I feel about that.
Yeah.
Events this week like 9/11, Missing Persons Day, mm-hmm. and the Parade of Homes. Also, a really cool benefit concert for the Idaho Falls Rescue Mission. We paid a visit to them this mm-hmm. week.
Yeah, that's a charity that's really close to my heart, by the way.
I was a guest on a raunchy podcast, and we'll talk a little bit more about the Eastern Idaho State Fair. Oh, and tell mm-hmm. you about a fantastic restaurant that we visited this past week mm-hmm. that we highly recommend.
Mm. And it's local.
H-O-T-T-O-G-O. You can take us hot to go. O-T-T-O-G-O.
I wonder how long it's going to be until some restaurant starts using that to advertise that you can, you know, get carry out orders.
Like Little Caesars.
Yeah, or something.
It's hot and ready. Is it good? It's hot and it's ready. IFAF. Is it good? It's hot to go. I love Chapel Roan.
I know.
My new fixation this week.
She kind of rules.
I would say she's the most compelling female pop culture icon since Lady Gaga.
Okay. Now, I think it's interesting that you specify female. So who do you think is the most compelling male?
There isn't one right now.
So wouldn't that make Bruno, her the most compelling?
Bruno Mars was.
He was.
You know, for a hot minute there.
Oh, he was great, like, too.
Olivia Rodrigo came close. Mm-hmm. But I almost truncated her name. Olivia Rigo.
Yeah, right?
No. But no, she's got the whole, let's see, she's lesbian. She's mm-hmm. She draws her fashion inspiration from drag queens.
Which I love.
I mean, she's just fabulous.
Well, and I just love that she's so willing to go out there and be extra.
Right. And I think that's a lesson to all aspiring pop stars mm-hmm. is don't step it up a notch. Step it up 10 notches.
Right. I mean, look at Bowie. There's a reason why he was so massive and continues to be a pop culture icon.
Right.
You know?
Honestly, if you think about it, there was no like power vacuum because there were still plenty of other talented female pop artists. Mm-hmm. But somebody had to come and really grab the bull by the horns and shake it up. Mm-hmm. And Chapel Roan has done just that.
Oh, I think so for sure.
If you don't know what we're talking about, do a hey, hey, play or a play Chapel Roan hot to go.
Right. That's a great one.
Smoking hot.
There are a couple of really good songs by her, though.
Yeah, she's got a couple. Mm-hmm. There's a YMCA dance to it where you mm-hmm. spell hot to go, H-O-T-T-O-G-O.
Uh-huh.
Is that going to be the new YMCA? Do you think grandmas are going to be dancing to it in 40 years?
Oh my gosh, that'd be amazing if it was, though.
How about straight to the comments and follow-ups?
Yeah, let's go for it.
All right. A TikTok user pointed out on our slightly terrifying video of the 100-year flood.
Oh, yeah, down in Utah?
In August, in Orem, Utah. Mm-hmm. And there's the Mormon Jesus with his arms outstretched and his palms facing up.
Right.
As if exasperated.
At least at some angles, I would say, for sure, he looks a little annoyed.
When he's looking down at floodwaters breaking through a basement window.
Right. Yeah. In that context, absolutely.
TikTok user pointed out that, hey, that's not the Mormon Jesus. That's so he must not be from around here.
Right.
Because it's definitely the Mormon Jesus.
Mm-hmm. But it's certainly the one that they've adopted.
That's a statue in Denmark mm-hmm. called Christus, mm-hmm. like Christ with a U.S.
Right.
Like Latin,
which is funny because it's not in the U.S.
Yeah, ouch. Yeah.
I'm stupid. I'm sorry.
But no, but it indeed was, I guess, a prominent LDS member or leader, mm-hmm. loved it, saw the statue, loved mm-hmm. it, got a copy made, gifted it to the church. Mm-hmm. And so, like, starting in the 1960s, the church, there's several replicas in visitor mm-hmm. centers across the world.
Oh, yeah.
And it's also, like, in their logo. Mm-hmm. They're using this Christus statue.
Right. Yeah. If they're not using Moroni, they're usually using this one. And I think a lot of them have switched over from using Moroni to using the Christus Jesus.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I did not know that. Thank you, TikTok. Mm-hmm. I've learned a ton of stuff this week.
Yeah. It's kind of been fun, huh?
Our insider talking about the teens in the McDonald's parking lot right. on Hit.
Yeah, how crazy is that?
Heard our segment and said, "Hey, wait a minute, guys! I didn't say Grease Lightning because that's what I thought. That's not my frame of reference for hooligans.
Okay,
I said Grease Lightning. I guess she hates Grease.
Hilarious, love it. Okay,
and she was talking about how when in Grease they think they're cool singing about Grease Lightning, right. but they're not.
Right. Okay.
So she meant that to be. Analogous, just
right. Okay,
for teens who think they're cool but aren't.
Okay, which is kind of funny because here's the thing.
So even though we haven't disclosed who she is, we're still allowing her to save face.
Yeah, which I think is fair.
Here,
now I will say, as someone who does like Grease, I did think they kind of looked cool. To be fair, I saw Grease when I was a kid, and it's now a sort of a nostalgia movie for me, so I don't give it the critical eye that I give a lot of other things, and that's probably why I'm still okay with them being cool in that moment, but yeah, fair enough, fair enough.
Okay. Also a follow-up, Haley Welch, the Hawk Tua girl.
Right.
Now has, I saw a trailer for it. Now has her own podcast.
Following in our footsteps, I see.
Guess what it's called?
What?
Talk to a.
Y'all really thought I was done? I'm just getting started, baby.
She's just the greatest.
She's good, dude. And also, I'm so impressed by how much she has taken this and absolutely run with it, you know? I think the real test is going to be whether or not she's actually good on the podcast.
Right.
But I'm going to assume if she was able to come up with that on the spot to begin with, she's probably going to be great on a podcast too.
I remember watching that, all of 5 second, 10 second clip
mm-hmm.
that we played a few episodes ago.
Right.
Going, she seems fun.
Right.
But not just because of what she said.
No.
Not thinking that, but just like, she's a wild one.
Well, and she's willing to make jokes.
Mm-hmm.
You know, a lot of people are kind of reserved and might, even if they think that, they won't say it because they don't want to be perceived a certain way. But she's cool with it, you know, and I actually kind of respect it.
I wonder if she was just mortified when that, because you're out on the streets. Oh, Nashville especially has a bar scene. As somebody who's been to CRS at least once.
Right.
The country radio seminar, they've got a heck of a scene.
Oh, yeah.
And I mean, like every single bar on Broadway, that whole street is just full of swinging joints.
Oh, yeah.
I just went there and had a little snack at each one for like 3 hours one night.
Oh, I bet they have good food, too.
Oh, yes, they do.
Like good bar food, you know, like just grease buckets full of like delicious fried veggies and stuff like that.
So she's out on the street one night, and then the next thing you know, she's world famous.
Mm-hmm. Well, and I love that it's her who got famous and not the interviewer guy, because I know he's clearly some clout chaser,
he's probably jealous of all
Right. Honestly, I'm impressed that she was able to capitalize on it so successfully. Good for her.
Good for you, Haley. Talk to a.
Yeah, if you ever want to talk to us, we'd be happy for it, but I'm sure you've got bigger fish to fry.
Do you remember, next follow-up, the Ross Dress for Less mess that we talked about last week?
I sure do remember it.
Oh, the comments.
Yeah.
Oh, the comments.
Well, you know, I would say that most of the comments were actually pretty positive.
Yeah, there were just a lot of them, and they were passionate.
Right.
Yeah, they're understaffed and work their workers to death. It's the same in every Ross I go to. Sadly, it's become the standard for corporations.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a consumer's job to fix a corporation's shit for them. They don't get paid enough to care, and it shows. Sounds like the same issue John Oliver did a whole episode about for Dollar Tree.
Which I remember, and he did a great expose on that.
Manager of the Dollar Tree looking straight into the camera saying, I'm the only one here. Our inventory's piling up in the back. You know, please help do something about this.
Right.
And then Dollar Tree responding with something like, oh, we make it very easy for our managers to express themselves. You know, not if they're going on TikTok.
No.
Sometimes I'll take care of a mess in front of me that bothers me, but it better not be a part of your business plan.
Right. That's what I was worried about, is that they're sort of expecting that from their customers.
Last week, we sort of left the hanging question, what are we teaching them?
Right.
If we go and help clean up their store, what are we teaching them when we give free labor to a multi-billion dollar corporation?
Right.
And finally, Aaron from TikTok says, I would help if they offered a 30% off discount.
I'm cool with that.
And I hear, I don't know for sure, I hear two, exactly two, members of the Greater Idaho Falls Chamber of Commerce took some personal offense to our comments about them, where they went down to Ross, put some things back on the shelves, made a video about it, and encouraged everybody to share that video and do the same.
Right.
All we said was, don't help a multi-billion dollar corporation and Chamber of Commerce stay in your lane. Well, so it's unfortunate they got their feelings
hurt. I'll say too is I'm really sad that they missed the parts where we actually complimented them. And we very actively said that we thought it was a very kind-hearted thing that they did.
The exact phrases
were, that their heart was in the right place.
Best intentions.
Yeah.
Heart's in the right place.
I understand.
They missed that part. I think they also missed earlier this year when we both promoted and attended both their speakeasy soiree and the grand opening of their Visit Idaho Falls experience.
Right.
Two individuals, we here, are very selectively picking things to take personally, and that's unfortunate.
Shame. Yeah, I'd like to be buddies, personally. Yeah. The biggest thing here is that we were never going after any particular person at all. We were talking about an idea. We were discussing what we thought were the cons of said idea, and frankly, we're not going to stop doing that. Because what this comes down to is what our community needs is good ideas that have been thought through and vetted by the community. You know, that's with any society. You can't just throw something out there and not expect some criticism of it. And
How dare we? How dare we call into question decisions made by not the entire chamber, just two dudes?
Well, and I know that we very specifically try to stay humble with criticism. And when we receive it, sometimes we absolutely don't agree with it. And we throw it aside and we say, sorry, you know, we have other evidence that shows this. We're going to stick to that.
We don't make uncharacteristically off-brand videos whining about it.
Right. I mean, the biggest thing is when we get criticism, we consider it and we either choose to discard it after considering it to its fullest extent. Or
is that how that works?
Or we actively choose to use it to better what we're doing. Because that's the end of it. Criticism isn't meant to knock you down and knock. Good criticism is never meant to just crap on you and knock you down a peg. It's meant to help you get better.
And we do it for everybody. Example, we've done it on the show before. Hey, Eastern Idaho State Fair. Boy, by the way, did we have a great time there this past week. Also, the name of your event is the Eastern Idaho State Fair. The sign on your gate says East Idaho State Fair. We believe that you ought to change either your sign or your name.
Right.
And we vote for your name because we love the ring of East Idaho State Fair.
It sounds better.
And that sign is a classic.
I agree.
Speaking of the fair, here's another one. Hey, Camping World, there's no I in the word comparable. Do you see how when we exchange ideas, we can all sort of help lift each other up?
See, and this might be a good opportunity for them to take this criticism and change their sign, maybe even go to their printer and give them a little criticism and say, hey, you should have spell checked this more.
Right. And I want to say the same applies to us. Do you remember when I got confused earlier this year? And for whatever reason, I had it all right in my notes. My brain misfired and I thought that Pioneer Day was June 24th.
I do remember that.
Not July 24th. I have a group of friends in my circle who I say, catch me.
Right.
The one who caught me on this one was one Jamie Prestwich. You may know her from her time at the newspaper and in radio, and now she's at Channel 8.
She's the best. She catches me on stuff, too. She's really good with that.
And we actually developed this system, I don't know, 7 years ago, 10 years ago, when we were working together at the same radio group.
Mm-hmm.
It just like, hell, check me on this.
Right.
That's all we have to say about that. Oh, except, good news, Ross Dress for Less has a new manager. And the place has apparently been cleaned up.
Yes. So I actually have a friend who recently worked there who I called up to get some insight. And he said that the previous manager had been begging for more staff for a long, long time because they've got some pretty bad issues going on. Specifically, they keep sending in massive volumes of items to the point where the organizational system that they had previously no longer works.
Oh.
Because they've got such great volume that they can't get through fast enough. On top of that, that manager had been begging for more bodies in the store for a long time and had been shut down time and time again by corporate.
So just because, like you said last week.
Right, exactly.
They set the hours and number of employees.
Exactly. But because it was one manager and not, for example, the Idaho Falls Chamber of Commerce, if they would have written in and said, hey guys, maybe you should get more people because we find this unacceptable, I have a feeling that they'd be a lot more willing to listen to them than some employee.
Okay, this is good. Now we've got new solutions.
Mm-hmm. And as a matter of fact, that's exactly what my friend that used to work there said. He basically said that he does think it was very kind-hearted for them to, you know, do some cleanup to make it shoppable in the moment. And as someone who worked there, he recognizes that it probably didn't do quite as much good as they were hoping it would.
And it would have been better to write, seriously, a strong-worded letter.
He said he would have rather that they spend those 15 minutes contacting someone higher than the manager and telling them that we need this to change as a community. He just doesn't see as much benefit from, you know, folks going in and doing this one thing the one time as he could see from us actively
trying to help that manager get more people. Yeah, right. This is a follow-up from way, way back.
Right.
Do you remember my skepticism about the whole Taylor Swift, Travis Kelce thing to begin with?
I do remember you talking about that.
It's about this time last year, if I'm not mistaken. Mm-hmm. Football was just starting.
Right.
They had just started dating.
Mm-hmm.
Rumors that Kansas City Chiefs tight end Travis Kelce's relationship with Taylor Swift was planned swirled all over the internet after an alleged contract with an exact date they would break up began appearing online. What's the date? September 28th.
Wild. Okay. When did this start popping up online? Do you know?
Last week sometime.
Really?
Since our last show.
Okay.
So, crazy. I mean, you think about all the extra buzz that the NFL mm-hmm. got and all the extra right. ladies that became viewers
mm-hmm.
of NFL games last year.
Right. Because of Taylor Swift.
Right.
I'm sorry. I got a shiver right there.
And so I don't want, you know, and I'll always admit it, too, when I think I'm being too Gen X, cynical, skeptical.
Right, right.
But maybe Mikey was right about this one.
Yeah.
A two.
Well, and frankly, when does Taylor even have time to date? She's currently on the Eras Tour, which is a massive undertaking. When does she see Travis? When would that even happen? So it would kind of make sense if, you know, she signed a contract to do a long distance mm-hmm. thing with someone to mm-hmm. get them both a little more publicity.
Yeah. I've got a single friend that I'm on a text mm-hmm. thread with another single friend, actually. Mm-hmm. And the topic came up about pickup lines the other day. And I said, oh, I've got a great one. What's your favorite era?
That's a good one, though.
Oh, but honestly, oh, and here's another thing I learned last week. My more reasonable other single friend said, hey, I hear the best way, have you heard this, to flirt with somebody is to like an old picture of them on Facebook.
Oh, do you think Instagram works that way too?
Yeah, I bet.
I would assume so, right?
Yeah.
But yeah, basically like an old photo of them on some social media.
And if they like an old photo of yours back.
Okay.
If they don't, it's over, move on.
Right. Then you're but probably just a creep do, in their eyes, but that's fine.
Yeah, we have disco.
Don't push it.
Right.
Yeah.
And I just thought, all right, there's somebody single listening right now who could use that tip.
I think that's genius, honestly.
Next up, and the last follow-up, it's time for some phantom tax. Karley, we all know that Karley loves quail eggs.
I do.
We went out, and we're going to talk about this later, too. We went out with our friends Lane and Whitney Virgin from Virgin Riverland and Cattle Company. And They got you a prize. I got Lane a t-shirt. Mm-hmm. Greg, thank you for the A's t-shirt. Lane loves it. He was like, no way. And Karley, they brought you a little gift.
A little tasty treat is what they brought me. They brought me some pickled quail eggs. I told my mom about it and she was like, that sounds disgusting. And I was like, what's wrong with you? That sounds delicious. So anyway.
Is there anything they go with?
Like, I mean,
honey mustard or?
To be fair, quail eggs can go with anything.
What about like just salt?
Oh, salt. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. I was thinking that we could use them for a little snack time today, right here on IFAF.
Treat time. Yay.
Thanks. Perfect. I'm going to go get them. Well, and one thing I was really excited about is that this particular one is from Bucky's.
Right.
And I've heard that the food at Bucky's is pretty dang good, so I'm expecting these to be tasty.
When we talked about Maverick's acquisition of Come and Go.
Right.
We also and other gas stations we've never heard of here mm-hmm. in the West. We also talked about Bucky's, which is primarily in the South, right?
Mostly, yeah.
Texas. Mm-hmm. But they're huge.
Yes.
And they're known like one Bucky's has the largest car wash in the world or something.
Right. They've got all kinds of crazy stuff going on there.
And apparently they have pickled quail eggs.
I know. How random.
All right.
I'm personally real excited. Also, I don't know why we don't have a Bucky's here yet.
Yeah.
Like, come on. We're kind of a great demographic for it. That one is.
I'm going to do pepper and salt. I think that feels like the right thing to do for me.
Now, I'm going to do my first one plain because I want to be a purist. I want to know exactly how it tastes right out of the jar.
Oh, gotcha.
But then after that, I think I'll throw a little salt, maybe a little pepper on one. Ooh, they're hard to grab, though. Maybe I should have done spoons instead of forks because they're kind of hard to stab.
Easy to stab. Was yours slipping around
a little bit? Yeah, mine kept slipping around.
Like a Rocky Mountain oyster?
No, those are fried enough. They don't really slip around.
Cheers.
Hmm. Okay. Now, I love pickled eggs.
They're okay.
I actually pickle my own eggs sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
So this is delightful to me. Mm. Mm-hmm.
Mm. Yeah, they're hard boiled with mm-hmm. vinegar.
They're kind of spicy.
Or by vinegar, I guess. Mm-hmm. Oh, are they...
Mm-hmm. You getting a little heat?
It looks like there's some jalapenos in that jar.
There are. Yeah.
Maybe that's why.
Yeah, they got a little spice to them. Ooh.
What's one serving?
Let's find out. 4 pieces.
Okay.
And one serving is only 45 calories.
How many grams of protein?
Ooh, let's find out. That's a good one. Let's see here. Ooh, 4 grams.
Okay.
Which for how tiny those are, that's right. 1 gram per eggy.
Okay. I'm going to have that's one more gram. That's pretty
good. Ooh, see? Protein. I can totally see myself in the middle of the night craving this and going to my kitchen getting some. Like, this is totally my kind of jam.
I wonder if, you really crave... things with lots of vinegar.
I do. Oh, salt and vinegar chips. Those are my favorite.
Right.
They're so good.
I wonder if you've got some sort of...
deficiency?
Yeah.
I've wondered that too.
Or imbalance.
You know, I've heard before that when pregnant women crave pickles and ice cream, it's because they're lacking something. And usually it's like a serotonin, I think. Okay. I don't remember. It's been a long
Does
time.
Does vinegar help with serotonin? Dopamine?
I have no idea. Probably. Hmm. I mean, the ice cream certainly would. Mm-hmm. But yeah, anyway, kind of crazy. Either way, this is delicious, and I am so excited about this.
While Karley's finishing up, we paid a visit to the Idaho Falls Rescue Mission to talk about this.
Yes. Now, this is a benefit concert, right?
Yeah, for acclaimed Christian artist Jason Gray.
Yeah, that's exciting.
Yeah.
Well, and especially for this particular cause, I'm really glad that they're finding ways to get a little bit more income for them because they need it.
Yeah, so we visited the Idaho Falls Rescue Mission. We met with the director of development, Chris Aspinall. Mm-hmm. Chris Aspinall is what we call him now.
Yeah.
And just we wanted to know more about what they do.
Right.
And they're a faith-based rescue mission.
Mm-hmm.
And because they're faith-based, they don't get federal funding.
Right, exactly.
You see where this is going?
Mm-hmm.
This is why we want you to buy tickets to this benefit concert, idahofallsarts.org. It's happening September 26th. That's a Thursday at 7 p.m.
Mm-hmm.
And we learned a bunch of stuff about the Idaho Falls Rescue Mission. First of all, right next door, they're at 840 Park Avenue.
Mm-hmm.
Right next door at 830 is Providence Downtown with my pastor buddy, Todd Wood.
Yes.
And they do a lot more than I thought they did.
Right.
I guess if I had to think about it, you know, just a few individuals on a daily basis. Oh, no. They serve 260 people a day.
It's a lot.
In some form or another.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they serve every night, 365 days a year. They serve 80 to 100 people for dinner.
Yeah, it's amazing. And it's all done through volunteer work, too.
And they house about that many, too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So one thing that I thought was really fascinating that he mentioned on our tour is the steps that they go through to prevent bed bugs.
Mm-hmm.
Because especially in the transient community, it's pretty easy to pick those up and it's really hard to get rid of them.
Stuff, yeah. You know, whenever you dive into something, mm-hmm. it's always going to be more detailed and complicated than you think it is.
Right.
They have a bed bug oven.
Yes. And they also have bed bug resistant mattresses too.
Yeah.
Isn't that genius?
It is.
Yeah.
We'll just do a quick tour for you.
Mm-hmm.
Check out their kitchen and dining facilities here.
Right.
Their food pantry that you can contribute to as well. They have clothing. You'll see that they have household goods like toiletries and stuff like that.
Right.
They put together little kits, don't they?
They do.
For mm-hmm. members in the community that need them. So,
well, and I know that there are other organizations that go to them for help too.
Right. Like they mm-hmm. send their case workers
uh-huh.
to the Idaho Falls Rescue Mission for those hygiene kits.
Right.
Idaho Falls Rescue Mission has been around for 25 years and they need three things. They need money, food, and volunteers.
Yep.
So if you want to help and have a great evening with some great music, Jason Gray, September 26th, that's a Thursday, 7 p.m., tickets at idahofallsarts.org or Lincoln Post. Mm-hmm. And thanks a lot. Chris is just a warm, generous man.
Right.
And thanks so much for giving us some of your time and letting us check out your operation mm-hmm. because one of my favorite charities has always been The Haven.
Yes. They are actually affiliated too.
I was the son of a single mom for a minute.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember how tough that was mm-hmm. on my mom. And so.
Well, especially back in the day.
Right.
You know, it's a little bit easier now because at least there's not nearly as much stigma, but.
Right. And so anytime I have anything to donate, it's always to The Haven. Well, right. Just a couple of years ago, Idaho Falls Rescue Mission took over The Haven.
Mm-hmm.
I think it was with ECAP or ICAP, however you want to pronounce the Eastern Idaho Community Action Partnership.
Right.
But now it's being run by the fine folks at the Idaho Falls Rescue Mission. So
uh-huh.
we wanted to put them in the spotlight this week so that you can help them help the community.
Right. And if you yourself want to get your hands dirty and go on over there and volunteer, we're going to actually put the application to do that in the post as well.
Time to sell your home. Make your move with Mike Helps Idaho. I help Idaho buy, sell, and invest in real estate. And I'm joined by Karley Morgan to help you even more.
You know we have insight on the Idaho Falls community, and we know the current real estate market too. And we're backed and brokered by the best. Keller Williams Realty, East Idaho.
When it's time to sell your home, make your move with Mike Helps Idaho. Lincoln Post.
Back to school means thrifting at Elsie's Closet Upscale Resale. They've got trendy fashion that's budget friendly. Elsie's Closet is Idaho Falls' only thrift store devoted exclusively to women and women's fashion.
And right now they have everything for back to school. Sneakers, pants, tees, bags, and jewelry.
Look for the pink sign just off Yellowstone on A Street. New customers use promo code IFAF to save 15% off your first purchase at Elsie's Closet. It's not just a stop at the thrift, it's a whole vibe.
Do you have an upcoming wedding or event? You don't have to do it all on your own. DIY Weddings and Event Rentals has great ideas for you, like the Polaroid guest book, candy salad jars, even a full-service drink trailer.
And everything you need, like backdrops, signs, dinnerware, and decorations. Call or text 208-403-2040 today. That's 208-403-2040. New customers use promo code IFAF to save 15% off your first rental at DIY Weddings and Event Rentals. Do you want locally raised beef for the holidays or to feed your family through the winter? Right now, Virgin River Land and Cattle Company is offering 25-pound butcher boxes with steaks, roasts, and ground beef.
Oh, I made a great Mississippi pot roast this week with that 4-pound chuck roast in the butcher box. For your own farm-to-table experience, find Virgin River Land and Cattle Company on Facebook.
New customers use promo code IFAF to save 15% on your first purchase.
For their 10th anniversary, Roof Rescue just gave away 4 free roofs to exceptional members of our community. The winners are Andrew and Elizabeth, teachers involved in youth athletics.
John and Ariel work to help feed the hungry.
JJ, volunteer firefighter, He and his wife, Margo, help with foster care.
Chris is in law enforcement and the Army Reserve. His wife, Sarah, is a teacher.
So congrats again from Roof Rescue, providing watertight peace of mind.
Did you have family or friends visit Idaho Falls this summer? Send them the best souvenir, a unique homegrown tee from Teton T-shirts.
Including these cool vintage versions of the Water Tower, the West Bank, and now the Civic Auditorium. Check out TetonT-shirts.com. Type that right into the URL field or click the link on this post. These exclusive designs aren't available in gift shops. Not even the Visit Idaho Falls experience.
No generic Darth Vader T-shirts here. TetonT-shirts.com. We're a real piece of Idaho Falls.
It is officially my favorite season, like literally right now.
Late summer?
And it yes, thank you. You know me so well.
I do.
It has been for a couple of weeks. And for the first time in a long time, the 10-day forecast shows high temps below 80. In fact, I think we're going to hit 64 this week and maybe a little
how
rain.
How crazy is that?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm kind of looking forward to it because I love being able to have my window open a little bit more and get some cool air that way. It's so much fresher.
And you can't wait to... Karley already has... I'm going to tell on you. Already has Halloween decorations up.
I do. I'm excited. I love Halloween.
At least one pillow. You have one...
I have one pillow and it's very cute. Pillow. Yeah.
You love the pink and orange like we talked about.
Yeah, I'm really digging it this year. Dude, I just think Michael's really hit it on the head with their Halloween decorations. Mm-hmm. I think they're so freaking cute. I can't wait for them to be 75% off so I can go buy more because I spent way too much money on them. It was not good. But I'm so excited to put them up because they're adorable.
Also, this week, of course, 9/11 on Wednesday.
Yes.
A couple of events on Wednesday. Anheuser-Busch hosting the annual 9/11 Memorial Stair Climb at their Idaho Falls malting facility. Now, the World Trade Center Twin Towers each consisted of 110 floors and 2,071 steps.
Wow.
The equivalent climb on the Idaho Falls Malt House, and you've seen it. You know how big it is.
It's big.
You can see it from clear across town, is seven times up and down.
Wow.
And they're going to do that. Police, firefighters, and Anheuser-Busch employees climbing, doing the Malt House's stairs to pay their respects and raise money for local first responders.
That's great.
Kind of cool.
Also, they are not going to have to do leg day for like a month.
Yeah, I hope they have been doing leg day for a month or two
in
preparation for this. Even walking around the fair, I got like shin splints and like tight calves.
It can be a lot sometimes. We did do a lot of walking, to be fair.
The Idaho Falls Fire Department will unveil and dedicate the Idaho Falls 9/11 Memorial to the community at 10 a.m. on 9/11 at the IFFD Station Number 1, which is at 343 E Street.
Oh, cool. Nice.
Yeah. And then September 14th is Missing Persons Day.
It is.
Our Spidey sense went off a few episodes ago. We knew this was coming up too.
Yeah.
And the reason we're interested in this is you have a friend.
Yeah. Who another local podcaster. She does the She's Missing podcast. And she also hosts this really incredible event to help bring awareness to missing persons cases right here in Idaho.
On Missing Persons Day.
On Missing Persons Day. Yeah. Matter
Which
of
is
fact,
September 14th. I don't know if I said that. Did I say that?
You did. Yep. So I hope it's okay that I cheat a little bit and read my notes here.
Do it.
But this is going to be taking place at noon in front of the Bonneville County Courthouse. They're going to be doing a service of remembrance for the missing. Audra Bergender, who's the aunt of Amber Hoops, a local missing girl. She was actually a huge driving force in establishing Missing Persons Day here in Idaho. And she's going to be one of the speakers alongside members of law enforcement and Emily, the host of the She's Missing podcast. It's going to be a great opportunity for folks to come out and show their support for families and missing people alike.
And plug for the podcast. Search your favorite podcast app for She's Missing.
It's a great podcast. Very well done. She covers cases in depth. And she actually talks to people who worked on the case.
Because their cases... that happened right here in East Idaho.
There's only one season so far, but she does have more coming, so stay tuned for that.
And coming this weekend, well, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, and next Thursday and Friday and Saturday, something that we are particularly interested in being real estate agents, the Parade of Homes.
Which I am always so excited for. I love creeping around houses. Not really. That sounds bad. I just like seeing, I love seeing the fancy houses. They're nice.
Absolutely. Especially new builds. You can see what's hot this year. Whether it's the kids' playroom under the stairs to make use of that space. Or whatever it is, you know?
One thing that I really liked was the sort of courtyard thing that they were doing, you know, where there was like a fire pit and some glass around the area so you could see out into it. I thought that was nice.
There are 17 homes. 11 of them are in Idaho Falls, 3 in Rigby, 2 in Rexburg, 1 in Shelley. What? No slick mansion on the lake by Island Park? No, it's none of those this year. So it's all. So you could conceivably hit all 17.
Yeah, maybe we should try.
Over the 2 weekends. Maybe we should.
Yeah, it'd be busy, but why not?
I just hope that Karley doesn't step on another drain pipe.
It was an accident. It was so embarrassing.
Especially at a Skidmore home.
Well, okay. Yeah, right? I'm going to become a menace in their eyes. And now, to be fair, it was black. And it was dark out.
That's true. There and you were no on the phone.
Yeah.
Getting a, yeah.
Right, yeah.
It was an important call. You were doing the pacing thing.
Yeah.
Crunch.
Yeah, I just stepped off the side and there it was and I just killed it.
And I will say, they each home builder has their own thing, but the Skidmore homes especially, they do those fresh baked chocolate chip cookies.
Those are nice.
I'll blow my diet for one of those. 10 of those, let's be honest. You can get your tickets at any one of the fine sponsors, Westmark Credit Union locations, ICCU, Ashley Furniture, and a couple of other places, I believe.
Nice.
Looking forward to that. Might see you there. Another huge event that eclipses all of the ones we just talked about. I'm kidding. It's last and least on the list is my birthday. It's my birthday week.
I think it's pretty important. I'm excited to do something special for you.
Ah.
Yeah.
It'll be fun. Really?
Oh, yeah. I've already got your gift.
We'll recap it next week. But yeah, it's my birthday week, and a buddy of mine knows I'm a huge Family Guy fan. And so he sent me this clip. Let me set it up for a second. Quagmire is at a bowling alley. His team just won a tournament. And he's loud and celebrating, and then this happens.
Excuse me, would you mind keeping it down? We're having my son's birthday party over here.
Yeah, sure, honey. What's his name?
Mikey.
Happy birthday, Mikey! Yeah!
Did you enjoy that clip? I did. And what's funny is, so I have two emails. My professional email, Mike Helps Idaho, for the real estate. And so I changed my personal email, I changed my name to Mikey.
Right. Yeah, which I think is cute.
So
I call you Mikey sometimes.
Right. So when replies come in, I can see which one of me they went to.
Right.
Professional me or thinks clips like that Family Guy clip are hilarious me.
Right.
All right. Speaking of thinks clips like that are hilarious me, I had a great old time with the boys this week, Karley.
You did, yeah.
I haven't had such a rowdy, raucous time since the last time I went and played poker with the boys.
That's good. Honestly, I'm glad. I think it's really important for fellas to have friendships, and I'm glad that you went out and you guys hung.
And we actually talked about that. I'm speaking, of course, of the OGs. In Idaho Falls podcasting, the original godfathers of podcasting in IF.
Well, and yeah, they've been doing it for what, 6 years now?
Jeff and Greg, they've been doing it. Coming up next March will be their 15th anniversary.
15?
15. They were talking about how.
Oh, I was so off.
When they first started, they actually needed an iPod to upload the podcast.
Oh, funny.
Right.
Wild.
Because podcasts were only on iPods.
iPods, yeah.
How about that?
Who'd a thunk?
And it was. It was very much a boys' club. Well, I'm glad you were busy that night.
Right. I have plenty to do anyway.
There's a link in this post. Before you click it, you should know that they take full advantage of their explicit label.
They do.
It's dudes being dudes.
Yeah. Who are really hanging, you know?
And it's interesting. After being on, I haven't been a guest on a show in like forever.
It's been a long time, huh?
So being on a show that had a different pace and kind of third wheeling it, and I still wanted to, I wanted to get a word in edgewise here and there, but I also wanted to let them do their thing because I was on their show. I was a stranger in a strange land. I was their guest.
Mm-hmm.
But they were so warm and welcoming.
Yeah, they seemed like sweethearts.
And extremely funny and crude.
Honestly, I
And I joined
that.
In.
Good.
And it was a lot of fun.
Good.
Okay, so we talked about vasectomies.
Uh-huh.
We talked about edgelords vaping horrific things.
Ooh.
How's that for?
I remember what you told me they were vaping, and it was disgusting and left me with so many questions.
I can show you the YouTube video if you want, but
I don't know if I want to see it. I can't decide.
I guess that's how they initiate first-time guests to their show. Thanks, guys. I could go the rest of my life without having seen that.
Yeah.
They do Urban Dictionary definitions.
Always fun.
Right. I, sort of like the BYU I fictional. Salacious acts that we've touched on before.
Right.
So anyway, wherever you get your podcasts, Jeff ampersand Greg podcast, episode 272, link in post.
Mm-hmm.
Speaking of BYU and BYU Idaho slang, lots of hashtags in the intro for the secret lives of Mormon wives. Roll it.
Yeah, kind of an interesting piece. I've only seen a little tiny bit of it, but you were saying that you've seen a couple of episodes now, right?
I watched the first episode and pretty much checked out, but let it roll in the background while I was transferring. I got a new external hard drive today.
Nice.
It's a Samsung T9 SSD. Ooh. It's like, yeah, really fast.
Are you really excited?
No.
You like your new piece of tech?
Yes.
I love it.
But I don't know what to think.
Yeah.
These ladies don't seem Mormon to me.
Okay, so here's the biggest thing. This is, by definition, trash TV.
Yes.
You know,
it, after the first episode, I realized this is just the Real Housewives repackaged.
Right, exactly.
And I hated that shit.
Exactly, right. So I have a feeling I won't really enjoy watching it in general. And I, the thing that drives me a little nuts about this is that I think that people who are actually in the Mormon church and practicing it as true LDS members, I think that they're interesting enough. I don't think we need to do this weird Mean Girls packaging for it.
Right. There,
you know?
So it's the ladies of, if you remember the hashtag mom talk trend on TikTok a couple years ago. This is sort of the aftermath of what ultimately ended up being a soft swinging scandal in Provo, Utah, Utah County, Happy Valley.
Yeah, weird, dude.
Right? Like they did you know, Karley, for instance, that you can swear as much as you want, drink as much as you want, be married and still have a Tinder account, cheat on your partner as much as you want, and still get married in the temple?
I would think
that was
not.
My takeaway. Yeah, well, I would think not, too.
Yeah.
So these ladies are going on global television talking about how they're doing all of that, but then still talking about their desire to, you know, get married, get sealed, have a bunch of babies. It's just it's the weirdest dichotomy I've seen in a long, long time. But we actually talked to somebody at the most recent wedding that we attended.
Yeah.
Who knew a few of these ladies.
Yeah.
I use that term loosely. They're let's see, they're in between the ages of 22 and 29 mostly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, young.
Young.
Mm-hmm.
And just bizarre, if you ask me.
Yeah.
It seems like, I almost wonder if the producers threw the word Mormon in there to make it some more scandalous and more salacious.
Right. Well, and that's even what our friend at the wedding said.
Yeah.
Was basically, they're only calling him Mormon because it gets people to click on it, and it's more salacious that way. And I would agree. And also, I mean, they do technically believe in the church, or at least at one point did, and still chose to do those things.
Right. Either believe in the main principles, or they're certainly not acting on them.
Right.
In the episodes that I saw. But or I know that a lot of people, and this isn't just for the LDS church, but a lot of people are member of churches just for the feeling of community.
Right. Which I totally get, especially nowadays where we are so atomized as a society. Having something like that where you can go to church and have buddies and have some kind of community is sort of necessary, you know, especially when people don't even know their neighbors anymore.
It's a way to help others and have a some support if you need it.
Right, too. Exactly.
I haven't decided, though. Am I on Team Taylor or Team Whitney? Taylor's a train wreck.
Right.
Like, got divorced, has another baby daddy, has an assault charge. So this all came to light. The soft swinging scandal came to light in May of 2022. Taylor was arrested for assault in 2023, and they must have already been filming for a little bit because they got a lot of that.
Right.
I mean, I think they got body cam footage from the police officers.
Crazy. Okay.
But then there's Whitney, who, if you remember, had the cringiest TikTok of all time. Her little son, Lee, was in the hospital with RSV, low on oxygen, and she does this dance. Like, first of all, just disgusting.
Yeah.
Exploitative. And look at the desperation in her eyes. Did you see that? She looks like, I gotta dance. I still have to create content. Yeah. No, you don't. You gotta take care of your son. Take care of your kids. I don't know who I was channeling just then, but
the whole thing,
it's disgusting.
The whole thing just feels very clout chasing.
Yeah.
You know, and
the lengths that people will go to either for that dopamine rush or the clout.
I kind of think that you have to be some degree of shameless to go on a show like this.
Taylor especially.
You know, I think, frankly, I could never, because I would be terrified of anyone finding out anything bad about me. Not that, and I guess I really
nothing
don't have,
matters anymore.
Right. Well, and I was going to say, I don't really have skeletons in my closet. Like, there's nothing that would be life-ending if anyone found out about it. But realistically, I don't like the idea of people, shuffling through my private life. That seems weird.
Well, and you can call it whatever you want, soft swinging.
Right.
But you may not be, but you're still doing a lot of sucking.
Yeah, that's weird to me. Okay.
And everybody, I guess, in this group.
Here's another thing.
Or most of them.
Here's another thing I'm going to say. So I was raised LDS, and I can't imagine being okay with it, believing in that faith, and not being just anxious all the time about dying. Like, what if you die before you have a chance to repent? I get that there's the whole afterlife and you can do it then. But also, the thing is, in the Mormon religion, you can't just sin with the expectation that you're going to repent later and God's going to be okay with it, because the whole point of repentance is that you have to actually feel bad about what you did and go to Him with a humble heart.
And that's sort of the feeling that I get from these ladies.
Yeah.
There's zero remorse.
I think that they really misunderstood repentance, and they think that it's just like a half-hearted, sorry, God, my bad, and good. It's like, no, dude, that's not what you're taught.
One point, Taylor actually said, I don't know when these guys are ever going to get over this. Like, if my timeline is correct, it's been a year or less since this all happened.
Right.
You know? Well, are we just supposed to forget about it?
Not only that, but, okay, when I was in the church, and I don't know if this has changed since then, but when I was in the church, I was basically taught that sex before marriage was just a little bit less bad than murder.
They said that on the show.
Right. And so I can't imagine, you know, being not only willing to do that once, but willing to do that just willy-nilly, and not being worried about God being like, mad at me. Yeah.
Well, we did ask Mormon Jesus for a response and his thoughts on the show, and here's what he said. Maybe we should start calling him Exasperated Jesus.
Kind of like Buddy Jesus, but...
Yeah, Buddy Christ from Dogma.
When he's had a real hard day.
Anyway, it's on Hulu, and I think the whole first season is up. I think they put all 8 episodes up at once.
Wild.
I'll watch it with you.
Yeah.
If you want.
Oh, I'll watch at least the first episode, get the vibe for it.
It's definitely one of those background shows.
Right.
As long as I'm doing something else, transferring terabytes of data and looking at cat memes.
Yeah. I can't imagine the mental capacity of someone who would have to give their full attention to that show to fully appreciate and understand it.
My attitude's changed a little bit ever since somebody explained to me, look, I know it's trash TV, but it really helps me to turn my brain off.
Right.
And sort of, it's a distraction from my own problems.
Yeah, absolutely.
So if you need something like that to shut your brain off before bed, I get it. But damn. It is kind of fascinating, though, being here in the Mormon corridor, watching mm-hmm. something happen so close to home.
Right, right.
And going to a wedding where mm-hmm. one of the bridesmaids knew these ladies.
She wasn't one of the bridesmaids. She was just a guest.
Okay.
But still.
But yeah, small world, small corridor.
Kind of funny, yeah. You know, here's the thing. I have a feeling that the whole show is just going to make me so mad because, like, honestly, I'm jealous. I'm jealous that they can go out and do as they please and not feel the crippling anxiety that I would have had I been doing the same things as them.
But, Karley, what does it profit a person if they gain the whole world, all the clout and all the money and all the fame, but lose their own soul?
Yeah, right. So true.
Bible, I think. All right. Next up.
Yeah, we have the excuse for not reading it. We're godless heathens over here.
We alluded to this earlier. Lane and Whitney, we met them at, we'd mm-hmm. been dying to go to Santa Maria. What
Style
is it?
Style Grilling.
Style Grilling.
Yes.
It's, if you're wondering where it is, it's basically the intersection of Hit Road and Highway 20.
Mm-hmm.
So north.
Yeah. So not really out of town, but a little bit out to the side.
And there were, I'm so glad to see a fabulous, successful restaurant in this location
mm-hmm.
because it's been a bunch of other things.
Right.
I know it was a coffee shop at mm-hmm. one point, and that's not coffee you want like in between work and home.
Right.
Or home and work.
Yeah.
Which would be the same thing, but I just go linearly to the...
Right, you're good.
you don't want to drive 15 minutes out of your way.
No, no.
Or 30 round trip. For a cup of coffee,
mm-hmm.
but you absolutely want to drive 30-minute round trip to go to Santa Maria Style Grilling.
Oh, for sure. Well, and it wasn't even 30 minutes for us. Round trip, I think it was like 20.
Yeah.
Helps yep. that I'm kind of a fast driver, but.
Uh-huh. Yeah. 9, you're fine. 10, you're mine. Remember that.
I know. That's I try.
Sometimes those ISPs have their sort of radar set to 10 over.
Right,
as I understand it. Because Lane and Whitney said, get there early so you can get the tri-tip.
Right.
That's what we highly recommend is the tri-tip. And you're mm-hmm. like, well, I can get tri-tip from Sam's Club and grill it up myself. How good can it be? I don't know how they do it.
Well, she did explain some of it to us.
She did.
Yeah.
Apparently, what's involved in Santa Maria style grilling is red oak.
Mm-hmm.
That's the wood you burn.
Yep.
On an open pit barbecue
mm-hmm.
using Susie Q seasonings.
Mm-hmm. Well, and here's the other thing, too. They very intentionally get their red oak from California because then it's sitting in the salty air and get some of that saline. Salt?
Yeah.
Saline?
Mm-hmm.
Saline.
From the ocean?
Yeah, on it. And so when it burns, it gives it that flavor.
So this is authentic. And we met with Nancy. Here uh-huh. she is.
She's the owner.
Great gal.
Super great.
Like worked 3 jobs to make mm-hmm. sure her kids got a good education, went to college,
mm-hmm.
and now she has successful kids.
Right.
And she's so proud of that.
Mm-hmm.
And she's so proud of the authenticity of this grill. It's really like nothing I've ever had
yeah.
here in Idaho.
I would agree. It's really good food, and the meat is just so well done. You can tell that she puts a lot of energy into this, and I will say, too, very, very clean establishment.
Yeah.
I was so impressed by how tidy everything was. You can see into the kitchen, and it's not like, you know, an explosion went off in there. Everything's very clean, very well maintained. You can tell that there's a lot of love that went into that location.
First, you got to get. What do you got to get? You got to get there early.
Mm-hmm.
Then you got to get the tri-tip sandwich. Here it is.
That one was good.
It's just a ton of savory tri-tip
mm-hmm.
on a hoagie roll.
We also got the tri-tip nachos, and those
yes.
were fantastic.
And that's what I love going out to eat with a bunch of people.
Mm-hmm.
You can all just share.
Yeah.
If everybody's
great.
Okay with it.
Oh, yeah.
I got the other thing you have to get is the peanut butter burger.
Oh, yeah.
It was so good.
Okay. So you had mentioned that you wanted to get a couple of burgers between the two of us mm-hmm. and that you wanted to share. And you were like, oh, do you want to get the peanut butter burger? And I was like, no, because I don't know if I like it.
So I did.
Yeah, so you did. And now I'm kind of mad that I didn't because that might have been my favorite thing that we had. It was such a dark horse. It was so good.
If you're wondering if it's weird good or weird bad, it was weird good.
So good. Yeah.
And not even all that weird, honestly.
Yeah.
Then you got what kind of
I got
burger?
The
it's like a just
avocado
avocado
Mexico burger
with some salsa.
Like yeah, it was good. It basically it just had some guacamole on it. It was really nice.
Just a great experience. Mm-hmm. Highly recommend Santa Maria style grilling.
Absolutely. Go spend your money there. Support local.
And finally, tonight, the Eastern Idaho State Fair is over.
I know. Yeah. Kind of sad. One thing I'm bummed about is that I did not get to see nearly as many critters as I wanted.
Mm-hmm. Sorry, Gutsmaster Buxton, that we weren't able to visit you at Allstate's Distributing, at your booth.
Yeah. I know. I was so bummed about that. I even tried to make time to go, and it just didn't happen. And yeah. I felt like such a butthole because I really wanted to go say hi.
But you did get your pickle pizza.
I did.
From Mama and Papa Leo's.
Oh, yeah. I bought like 5 slices. Yeah. I bought a lot of pizza from them.
Also, at Mama and Papa Leo's, I saw this ad for this potato. And I was like, oh, okay, they're doing baked potatoes. Uh-huh. And she must have read my mind because she goes, that's all ice cream.
Yeah.
Okay, imagine a potato-shaped lump of vanilla ice cream coated in like a chocolate cinnamon. What was that concoction?
It was like a cocoa powder.
To make it look like a potato.
It looked just like a potato.
Split in half.
Uh-huh.
Lord knows what they used for the things that looked like bacon and the stuff that looked like cheese.
Yeah, so what they used for the stuff that looked like cheese was cake.
Wow.
It was just bits of cake. And they had whipped cream for the sour cream.
Brilliant.
It was so smart, and it was so good,
and
too.
And tasty.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's sort of cognitively weird because you look at it and you feel like you're about to eat a potato and then it's ice cream. But man, it sure was tasty.
Yeah, TikTok that.
Uh-huh. Another thing that we got to try that was actually an exclusive, which I was really excited for, we went to Yankee Can Cook because I had to have some of their deep fried cheesecake because it was just so good. Mm-hmm. But while we were there, she actually told us about a new menu item that she's planning to put on, especially after we said she definitely should, which was deep fried cookie dough. Now, not the same as deep fried cookies. Very different, I would say, even.
It was delicious.
And it came out so ooey and gooey and just like,
please go with that next year.
Yes, absolutely. And I did tell her directly that I thought mega stuffed Oreos would be a better fit for the deep fried Oreos.
I believe.
And it was funny because she said that her son said the same thing.
I believe last episode you said it ought to be an O, re, 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 O.
Yes, I stand by it, and it sounds like others agree, so I'm excited about that. But yeah, we had a really great fair food experience this time.
I almost forgot about the cinnamon almonds, but I got them right as I was heading out.
Oh, so good.
And I discovered my favorite new fair food.
Uh-huh.
A place that I guess has been there since 1970.
It's been there a long time.
Bimbo Dogs.
Yes.
Now, this t-shirt, it's from Bimbo's, but it features their burger.
Uh-huh. Their dogs are where it's at.
Okay. So we went one night. You're like, hey, have you ever had a Bimbo dog? I'm like, no, what's that?
Yeah.
You mentioned it last episode. I didn't stop and ask you what it was.
Mm-hmm. You smelled those onions and you were like, oh, that smells really good. And I was like, yeah, those are the Bimbo dogs. And finally, that's when you asked for clarification. I told you what it was and you just lit up.
That's the other thing I learned last week.
Mm-hmm.
They're freaking delicious.
They're so good.
And I guess I had to wonder about the name.
Mm-hmm.
Bimbos.
Right.
She said that it was, you know, established 1970, as the shirt says.
Uh-huh.
And she says that it was originally owned by either the church or a local chapter,
owned by the church.
But then at some point they divested and sold it to some guy.
A couple of families.
Yeah.
And then one family bought out the other family and now they still own it.
One of the guys was named Odell, and I said, the Odell's furniture guy? Yes. The very same.
Yeah.
And so I had to go and Google the word Bimbo.
Right, because it'd be weird for the church to own a place called Bimbos nowadays.
Well, but not really, if you understand the etymology of the word.
Right.
Apparently, Bimbo comes from the Italian, meaning small boy.
Yeah.
And in the early 1900s, about 100 years ago, it was just used in that fashion.
Right.
And then it sort of became a gender-neutral term for a minute to refer to any young person.
Right.
And then it sort of fell out of fashion for a good 40 years until the 80s.
Mm-hmm.
So a good 10 years after this hot dog and hamburger stand that does delicious sautéed onions was named.
Right.
Then it took on the meaning of a, I don't know, a dumb.
Yeah. A dumb, loose person.
There you go.
Yeah.
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 And then, of course, came himbo.
Yes.
And all the other variations.
Yeah, yeah.
But, yeah, it didn't really have any meaning.
No, not really.
It was sort of a combination of Bambi and Dumbo, I think.
Yeah, yeah. Well, and it is, like, if you just look at the word, it's kind of a fun carnival-sounding word.
Yes.
You know?
Exactly. Sounds like a clown.
Right, absolutely. And Bozo, that's even what they're... Bimbo. Yeah, that's even what their logo is a clown.
Yeah.
And my parents always take home Bimbo dogs from the fair to enjoy later.
Which is great.
So that's why I made sure I did that too. And that's why I was surprised that you'd never had one before.
And look at this onion porn.
Oh.
We're just going to leave the camera on this for a second.
It was pretty impressive.
Got a hot grill, pouring the butter on it, and then, I don't know, it's hardly 30 seconds before he flips them.
Uh-huh. And they're already caramelized to perfection.
So good. And to beat that, they said, you want some sauerkraut on that? Yes, I do.
Yeah.
And then to beat that, I went back the next day with my own, in Karley's picnic basket, stone ground mustard.
Mm-hmm.
So here's what we want to leave you with. As I'm standing at a table at the Eastern Idaho State Fair by that sort of stage that's by the bathrooms, I'm listening to a guy do Tennessee whiskey, Chris Stapleton. I'm like, this guy's good.
Mm-hmm.
Wrapped up my lunch, started walking away, and then he burst into Etta James At Last.
Kind of a weird follow-up song.
And I was like, okay, this guy's too good.
Right.
Come to find out, it's a kid I know from way back in the day. Mm-hmm. CJ Holverson, what's up?
Oh, funny.
Siler James was the sound tech for Voltstar.
Uh-huh.
And he was just doing a 15-minute little fill set.
Oh, nice.
Until the next artist came along. That guy is talented. Last I heard, he was in L.A. literally playing hockey with Justin Bieber.
Whoa.
In Burbank.
Okay.
Because Bieber, the Biebs,
plays,
he's Canadian.
Well, I mean, yeah. If you're Canadian, you have to play hockey. That's like in their constitution.
Anyway, please, Eastern Idaho State Fair, or if you change your name, East Idaho State Fair, can you please book this guy for a real gig? He's way too good.
Right.
To be doing just sound.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to leave you, at the risk of a copyright strike, we're going to leave you with a little bit of his rendition of Etta James' At Last. Enjoy.
Subscribe on YouTube, and we'll see you next week.
Stay fresh, cheese bags. Oh, you are mine, at last.